The first thing I want to say about this Kratom bill, I saw some of the testimony on all this written testimony. I want to make sure anybody that's watching on the cameras or whatever, we're not banning it. No ban. No B-A-N. No ban. Bill Post doesn't ban things. Okay. So just want to make sure that's very clear on the record. The other thing is to hear me talk about getting government involved is like literally pulling teeth without Novocaine. I don't like government. I don't like government involved, but I feel like occasionally government has to be involved in something. And in this case, I would invite you, if you haven't already, is to Google K-R-A-T-O-M, Kratom, 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 however it's pronounced, it doesn't really matter, but you'll find that Kratom is good in its pure and natural form, and you'll hear from experts about that, but what's being sold in Oregon might not necessarily be Kratom. It may be something else, or Kratom, a little Kratom with some other stuff in it. And some of that is in the bill, and I'll highlight a couple of things. The other thing is, as you'll see in this system, is built in a fee base. The industry, and they'll talk about it, the industry is willing to pay a fee to ensure this program moves forward that I'm proposing, and that will offset the cost of the state. And the good thing is it will also make it so that we don't have to come back every 2 years and ask for money. Oregon Department of Agriculture. So I think that really takes care of everything, and I'll just turn it over to the experts. But this was brought to me last year after the long session. The industry itself said, help us. We need help, because it's kind of the Wild West right now in Oregon when it comes to Kratom. So I appreciate your time and indulgence, and look forward to hearing what the other folks have to say.